Good morning, everyone. Jeff Dill here from Firefighter Behavioral Health Alliance. I'm just out on a walk here in Anthem, Arizona. Beautiful morning. It is my way of practicing self-care. You know, when things get on my mind and loaded on my mind, and doing what we do, tracking and validating firefighter and EMS suicides. So this is my self-care. And it got me thinking as I'm walking about one issue that we've really started to hit here at Fbha. And so welcome to week 33, Breaking the Silence. It's called Adrenaline Junkies. And of course, I'd like to thank Angel Sanchez from Phenix Fire Helmets for their support, undying support here for Fbha and our efforts here in 2017. But the Adrenaline Junkies. And, you know, I also want to say to my brothers and sisters that responded to the massacre there in Las Vegas, you know, thank you for your services and understanding that when we got on this job, we didn't expect to see things like this. Good morning, Larry. How are you, sir? Hope you're having a great day. That we didn't expect to see things like what we did and just the mass casualties that were just absolutely horrific. But like I said, it brings along the point that we talk about in our travels. And like I said, I travel about 130,000 air miles every year visiting fire and EMS organizations. And this adrenaline junkie, you know, the thrill of the calls that we might get and the excitement that brings us to this job. And understanding that over time, many of us, it occurs to us that, you know what? These things play a part in our mental and behavioral health makeup. And that adrenaline of running the calls, it becomes sort of like of an addiction. And that's why I'm standing in front of the Starbucks Cafe, because I'm not a coffee drinker, but I see so many that have that addiction for Starbucks coffee. And that's how we are in the fire and EMS world. We have this addiction to run to calls and the excitement to help out our brothers and sisters, and it fills us with that adrenaline. But understanding that, you know, we have these things that are going off, and I don't know what that means, Larry, that there's no off button. Oh, I see, I understand. Yeah, there's no off button for the adrenaline. Absolutely. And, you know, that's why we have to start practicing that internal size up. You know, why am I acting this way? Because in time, many of us go through these issues of struggling with, oh man, I've seen enough. There's just, I can't take anymore. And yet we want to keep on going and going. And there's nothing wrong with these adrenaline junkies that many of their part-time jobs are other fire and EMS. And they're going from one station, one department to another. And my question is when do you allow your brain to recover and recoup from these adrenaline rushes and the things that we're seeing and doing? And if we don't practice self-care early on, what price will we pay in the future? And so, like I said, there's nothing wrong with wanting to help out our brothers and sisters and going from one department to another to help out, but understanding that these adrenaline rushes, they might pay a price we might in the future. So practice self-care. Take care of yourself and understanding and relieving the stress and anxiety of running all these calls. So please, once again, I thank my brothers and sisters that were in Vegas and helping out the community there that was just shocked by the mass shooting. But please understand that self-care at this time is imperative for you, is to either maybe seek some counseling, talk to a chaplain, understanding your reactions to those things. And I don't care, you could be a volunteer out in somewhere in Idaho. And, you know, these are issues that, that we deal with because we work in that community. So practice self-care, because we know in our data of 1,057 fire and EMS that have taken their lives, there are no discriminations. Doesn't matter if you're career, volunteer, fire, EMS, ages, ranks, please practice self-care. Start looking into it today. Start working with it with your peer support. Find counselors, find resources. Take a walk on a beautiful day like I'm doing here in Anthem, just listening to country music. Thank you, my brothers and sisters, for all that you do out there. But also remember to take care of ourselves. It is absolutely imperative. So please, anyone, and yes, Jonathan, absolutely. and easy on alcohol or drugs for a while. You know, that many of us turn to those type of addictions to help self-medicate ourselves. And we know, we're in this business, we absolutely know that that doesn't work. So please, find some healthy self-care type of methods. Like I said, a counselor, a chaplain, taking a walk, exercising, just talking. Talking about the things that you've seen and done can absolutely help and alleviate all those stressors and help alleviate being those adrenaline junkies. So my brothers and sisters, thank you so very much for all your support for FBHA. It is deeply appreciated. To Phenix Fire Helmets, thank you so very much for believing in our mission and supporting our mission. We get very few manufacturers that have that undying faith in us like Phenix Fire Helmets. So once again, brothers and sisters, Jeff Dill from FBHA, practice that self-care, take care of yourselves. It's a great job, I know. I lived it and truly enjoyed it. Be good to yourself.